Now to Mr. Chris Smith of New Jersey, Chairman of the Africa and Human Rights Subcommittee.
And welcome, Madam Ambassador. Just a couple of points. First of all, I do believe delay is denial, and I think we have a de facto defensive weapons arms embargo on Ukraine. And it's reminiscent to me, at least, and perhaps many others, to the Balkans War, when we, in a totally misguided fashion, ensured that Bosnia and the Croats, the Croatians, did not have the ability to defend themselves against Milosevic's aggression, and now we see a reprise of that happening to our good friend and allied Ukraine. When you get the Secretary of Defense, Ash Carter, James Clapper, and as one of my colleagues already mentioned, and I've read his speech, and it's an excellent speech that was given by our top military commander, Lieutenant General Ben Hodges. He has made a number of important points, I think, in his speech, perhaps chief of which is that while Ukraine's defensive capability might not necessarily turn the tide overnight or soon when it comes to the military situation, it will make the diplomatic solution more probable. And that's exactly what happened, as we all know, when the Croats broke the arms embargo. It wasn't NATO bombing that initially turned it all. It was the Croatians who were able to break the arms embargo and put Milosevic to flight. And I think, you know, the Ukrainians are waiting for the kind of ability to defend themselves. You know, the president's advisors are all saying, do it, Mr. President, and he has refrained from doing it. It is baffling. When you get two world leaders between September and yesterday publicly admonishing President Obama in joint sessions of Congress, it is time to wake up, I believe, respectfully, and take their views into much greater account. You know, as my colleagues have said, and I believe it as well, delay is denial. People are dying, over 6,000 are dead, many of those are children and women, and, I do think it may even bespeak another issue, and that is the hollowness of our military increasingly. We're not there yet, thank God, but we are on a glide slope to being weakened because of defense spending. But as General Hodges pointed out, Germany, and we know Angela Merkel has admonished not to go with the military defensive capability, only 42 of Germany's 106 Typhoon fighters are available because of maintenance, 38 of its 89 Tornado bombers. General Special Forces had to pull out of a joint exercise because there was no working helicopter. A hollow force is an engraved invitation to Vladimir Putin to continue his aggressive ways. So I think the alliance itself and the United States needs to step up and help the Ukrainians. I was in Europe 2 weeks ago for an OSCE winter meeting. And the Ukrainians, and while they don't want to say this publicly, just like Netanyahu was effusive in the opening speech, part of his speech with praise for Obama, they don't want to say it publicly. They need us. So they have to tread lightly and walk on eggshells. But they told me off the record how profoundly disappointed they are in President Obama, especially in light of people around him saying, please, Mr. President, this is a time for American leadership. So, you know, when will that decision be made? You know, the pipeline took 6 years, and then finally we found out where the president really stood when he vetoed the bill for the Keystone Pipeline. What is it, next week? Is it tomorrow? You know, there's statements by Poroshenko today admonishing the, and it's right from our embassy, admonishing the European Union not to be premature, his word, in being optimistic about where Minsk II is taking us. And again, there are also parallels, and I thank God for the 452 OSCE monitors around the ground doing wonderful work. But it is reminiscent, again, of what happened in Croatia and Bosnia when the European monitors were there. And I remember meeting with them with their white suits on and score pads. How many people were being killed? How many being raped? It was horrible stuff. And they were brave as can be, no weapons. Well, the OSCE monitors in that same boat. They need defensive weapons. They need them now. Yield to answer. Tomorrow, maybe? Are we going to find out for the president? Delay is denial.
Thank you, Congressman. I think, as you heard in my opening statement, we are watching the implementation of Minsk. We do have concerns now about new firing on the ground in the last couple of days. I do think that the environment and whether this is implemented will affect the calculus, both on the sanctions side and on the security support side.
Okay, but hopefully soon. I mean, the Ukrainians are suffering so much. Nadia Savchenko, the pilot, member of the parliament, She's in her 82nd day of a hunger strike. What do we know about her, and what are we doing to try to effectuate her release?
We have grave concerns about her condition. We believe she was illegally abducted across the border and that she is being illegally held, that if Russia wanted to give a humanitarian gesture, there would be nothing more impactful that they could do quickly than to release her today. We have concerns about her health. She was seen by a European doctor last week or 2 weeks ago. But as you know, when you are taking in no calories, every day matters. So we, in every meeting we have at every level, notably including Secretary Kerry's meeting with Foreign Minister Lavrov over the weekend, we raise her condition and ask that she be released immediately.